Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to your Order of Operations video lesson in our Order of Operations unit. The target today is that I can evaluate expressions with the Order of Operations. There are going to be a couple images on these slides that can help you remember the order of PEMDAS and what it stands for. You don't need to write all three of them down, but you do need to select one to choose from. This is one of them that you can write down, PEMDAS, showing the parentheses. Also, sometimes I learned it as GEMDAS for groupings. These are the various groupings. This square root can also be considered under exponents, but it does group things together. So that is the order. If that's one that you're going to copy down, pause here. There is a lot of vocabulary in this lesson. Numerical expressions are, for example, 4 plus 3, 6 times 2, 10 divided by 2, anything that has numbers and operations. So a numerical expression is a number sentence where there are numbers and at least one operation. The order of operations, what you're learning, the PEMDAS. This is the order in which we solve mathematical problems in the correct order. So if you went out of order, you would not get the correct answer. So it is the order in which we operate in mathematics. Grouping symbols show numbers that are meant to be together, and that is the P of PEMDAS, sometimes GEMDAS people learned it as. And there are various kinds. There are parentheses, brackets, braces, the fraction separates, and the square root separates things that should be done in a specific order. Kind of fast on that because I want to get to the problems. Make sure you are aware of vocabulary and you're using it when you discuss things regarding to order of operations. So again, this is another one of those charts that you can write down if you so choose. So pause here if you want to. It's just an acronym to help remember is please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. Since Miss Simmers is now an aunt to the wonderful prairie, some might remember it as please excuse my Aunt Simmers, my dear Aunt Simmers. My dancing Aunt Simmers, because I'm so jumpity. And remembering that multiplication goes from left to right, and addition and subtraction go left to right. Otherwise, this is the order we do things in. Have that written down. The third option for you to write down is simply a chart that has steps on it. So you can pick one of those three, or all of them if you really want to. Evaluate the expressions inside grouping symbols. That's the P part. Evaluate all powers. Those are exponents. Multiply and divide left to right. And add and subtract left to right. So our MDAS. So we're going to try some. So evaluate, we learned, remember, to find the value of. So, and justify each step. So why did we do it? When I solve, I make a checklist for order of operations. I check it off as I go. So I rewrite my problem. And I see parentheses, so I do that first. 5 plus, what's in parentheses? 12 minus 3 is 9. There's no exponents. There are no multiplication, no division. There is addition. 5 plus 9 is 14. You're going to notice as I solve, I work down kind of like a carrot. You should be funneling down your work. Next one. Might make myself a checklist over here to justify my steps. There are no parentheses. I better rewrite it first. No parentheses. There are no exponents. There is multiplication. So I do that first. 3 times 2 is 6. And I rewrite the rest of the problem. There's no division. There is addition and subtraction. I don't do the adding first. I need to remember that these go left to right. So I need to go from the left to the right on those. So I see subtraction first. I rewrite. Add those together for 9. So now would be a good place, if you're feeling okay with your order, to try some. If you're not quite there, maybe you follow one more and then try the next one. Making my checklist. Think about why I would do this. How is it helpful? Maybe it could be for you. parentheses first. 39 divided by 9 plus 4, which is 13. No exponents, no multiplication. My last step is division. 13 goes into 39 three times. Hopefully you're trying this one. My checklist. I'm going to do no parentheses, no exponents, no multiplication, but there is division. So I do 10 plus 8 divided by 2 is 4 minus 6. Addition and subtraction, and they are left to right, so I just work left to right. 14 minus 6 evaluated for 8. Couple more. Again, you might be feeling ready to pause. These ones are going to involve exponents. So, there, rewrite it. Remembering that square, that means 3 times 3, not 3 times 2. So no parentheses, but there are exponents. So I do 5 plus, this is the same as 3 times 3, so I get 9 minus 7. There's no multiplication, there's no division, there's addition and subtraction. I work left to right. 5 plus 9 is 14, minus 7, 14 minus 7 is 7. And notice I'm always rewriting my steps and I'm working down. Try some. Be brave. It's okay to make mistakes. Learn from them. I'm going to write a checklist on each of these. So, remember this 10 to the 4th is the same as 3 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. So I'm going to do that exponents first, still remembering this is by itself. So I have my 3 times 10 times 10 is 100 times another 100. So I work those out. So that's 3 times 10,000, which is going to be 30,000. Working down. Order of operations, parentheses, 5 minus 1 is 4, and that's cubed divided by 4. Exponents, 4 cubed is 4 times 4 times 4, so I get 64 divided by 4, which is division, which is 16. It's okay if you have to take a little bit more time on these. Checklist. So I do parentheses first, so I rewrite 14 plus 3 times 7 minus 2 is 5, parentheses, no exponents, multiplication comes before addition, 14 plus 15, no division, just addition left, 29. Last one of these regular ones, parentheses, so I rewrite 6. Plus 8 divided by 2 plus 2 times 3 minus 1 is 2. No exponents. There is multiplication and there is division. I have to do them left to right. So I do 6 plus 8 divided by 2 is 4 plus 2 times 2 is 4. So I did both of those and I did them left to right. Since they were separate, I could do that. I could also do them one at a time and then rewrite. So I do 6 plus 4 is 10, plus 4 is 14. Go back and review whatever you need to. Take your time and practice. Last one, we're going to apply this to a word problem. Juan goes to the school book fair where paperback books are $1.50. Hardcover books are $3. Juan buys 5 paperback and 2 hardcover books. We're going to write a numerical expression to find out how much he paid, and then we're going to solve. So we necessarily know that paperback is $1.50, hardcover is $3. He bought 5 of these and 2 of these. So instead of repeated addition, we can show repeated addition with multiplication. So we can say 5 books at $1.50 each plus 2 books at $3 each. Use our decimal information. So I know 2 would be 350, 4 would be, or 2 would be 3, 7. So this is going to be $9.50. If I'm not sure, I can do it over here. Multiply. Oh, 750. See, I made a mistake. That happens. Got to be careful. Got to check. And then I add, and I get $6. Notice how I just learned from my mistake, and I checked. So then I add them together for $13.50 is what Juan paid. So remember to record your notes, take good notes, write down questions, and take your NYQU quiz, rewatch if you need to, go to the book if you need to, and go to the online book if you need to. All these resources just for you to be successful.